Hi everyone, welcome to Ansible learning series for network engineers. In this series I'll be demonstrating how to use Ansible for network automation. This includes some real-time examples using Cisco and Arista devices. So this series will be helpful for the network engineers who would like to learn about Ansible. Ansible is basically an automation tool. Using that you will be able to manage configuration, state of the devices, provisioning of the devices, etc. So Ansible supports wide range of devices. So if you want to see the supported devices, you can go to the module index. So this is the module index page. So you can see this supports multiple modules. So this is the module mainly which we are going to look, network modules. So under network modules you can see the vendors it supports, the list of vendors and devices it supports. Here you would be able to see iOS, yeah, so these are some of the actions it supports in Cisco devices. Similar way you can find iOS devices. These are the tasks supported in iOS devices. These are the tasks supported in Juniper devices. You can see those details in the network module list. Typically, it communicates to devices using SSH or HTTPS. In case of network devices, it uses SSH, netconf, APIs using HTTP or HTTPS. When we come to basic concepts, in Ansible, there are concepts like inventory, task, playbook, modules, etc. So inventory means it contains list of all the managed devices. You can see some details about inventory here. If you're interested, you can go and read those details. Then about task, the actions what Ansible performs, the task in the module index you can see the type of task it supports. So under network module you can see the task it supports for each devices. And playbook means playbook can contain multiple tasks. You can create your own list of tasks and that is called playbook. You can run multiple tasks from a single playbook. That is the advantage. So sometime when you want to automate a scenario, like you need to run a command in the device, check if that condition is met, you need to execute another command. So those kind of things you would be able to do using playbook. You can add multiple tasks. So there are modules, depends on type of task there are modules. The primary module what we are going to look is network module. If you would like to see how to install Ansible, you can go to the installation guide here, and here you will be able to see how to install it on different flavors of Linux. So I'm using Ubuntu, so I followed this method. Once you install it using these commands, you will be able to see a folder in etc. So the folder name is Ansible. Inside that, you will be able to see ansible.config file and host file. So these are default files now. I haven't edited it, I just kept these files as it is. Now to see the content of ansible.cfg file, so everything is commented here. You can see a hash in front of all the descriptions and all the inputs. So nearly all the parameters can be overridden in Ansible playbook. So these are some of the parameters. So inventory file is the host file inside etc ansible folder. Then some library details. Then So once we start editing the configuration file, we will come and see all the details. Now I'll keep everything as default and I'll show how to initiate a basic connection. So there are a lot of details here. So one main change what you need to notice now is host key. So record host key will be true by default. So host key checking will be true by for default. So that means whenever we initiate any SSH connection to the device, it'll validate whether that host is trusted or not. So we might be able to edit this property. Anyway, we'll come back to this later. So now we'll keep everything as default. Now if you want to see the details of host file, so here also everything is commented. Now they are given some examples. So what it says, you can either give host name or IP address, and these are examples of some ungrouped host, and this is a group name web servers, and they have showed how to add some host under a group, and then even you can create a group of groups. And here is another example of defining a host range. So name 99.1.1. So that's all about host file. Now we will see how to get output from a Cisco device. So I have a Cisco device here, I'll log in and show you. Its IP is 10.10.10.10. So this is running Cisco iOS version 12.4. I have just configured my IP address and enabled SSH. Now to see some examples of how to initiate a connection to a device, we'll go to the Ansible guide. So here you can see, run your first network Ansible commands. I'll copy this syntax and I'll put it in a notepad. Here in this example they are using ViOS, and this is the host name which they are using. In our case it is an IP, it is 10.10. and this comma is very important because otherwise it will point to the inventory file. So I'll show the error what we get if we don't give this comma. And next is -c. -c means the connection method it uses is network CLI, then the username what we are going to use, and -k will prompt for the password. Then the module name, in our case the module is going to be ios_facts. I'll show that module. Then -e stands for the extra variable. So we use the OS, iOS, Ansible Network OS is iOS what we are going to use. So we'll edit this. So initially I am going to demonstrate how to initiate without any playbook. In the upcoming videos we will see how to use playbook. So this is without playbook how to initiate a basic connection. So here in our case is going to be IP, and the username is going to be admin, and the module is going to be iOS facts, and network OS is going to be iOS. If you want to see the module iOS facts, we'll go to the module index under network modules. We'll search for iOS facts. Yeah. Yeah, this is the task which we are going to use now. Now let's try to execute it. First, let's try to execute without comma and see the error. So Ansible is asking for this password, the device is not prompting. So what the error what we are getting is unable to pass this. So it considers this as an inventory file. But if we give comma here, we can give multiple devices here. We'll see those later. So I'll give the password. Yes, this is the output what we received. So it has passed the complete data and got the output. We have one more device here, we'll try to connect to that as well. Yeah, we got the output here. In case if you get host key not found error, so what you can do is edit the etc Ansible configuration file. Just make this to false in case if you get host key not found error. Now instead of giving IP address, if you want to give the host name, what you can do is you can edit the etc host file and map the IP address to a name, etc host file. So here I have already mapped 10.10 to D1. So if I ping to the device D1, it will go to 10.10. Similar way, I'll add 11 as well. And give that as D2. Yeah, 11 also is pinging. Now if you want to connect to multiple devices, D1, D2. Yeah, now we'll be getting the output of both devices in the same session. Yeah, so we got the output of both devices. So you can see the output, it is in a structured way. You will be able to pass it and use it as a variable anyway. So in the next video, we'll see how to use the Ansible playbook. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.